Hey everybody, just a quick bonus video here. One of the great things about Black Friday or these Thanksgiving sales and pre-Christmas jump off things is that a lot of retailers are looking to try to get rid of things that they may have had surplus of at a greatly reduced price. Our older technology, as they're trying to flip through things and, you know, unleash new technology to folks in the coming months. But I like to take advantage of that because what's old for some folks is new to me, and falling in that bucket is something that I picked up on Thursday through Newegg, and they're the Pivothead sunglasses with the camera in them. So we're going to take a look at them today. So as you can see in the package, these Pivothead glasses record in 1080p HD, and they have an 8 megapixel still camera. I'm trying not to stumble over my words here. These glasses have been retailing for $200. On Black Friday, they were retailing for $169 for the glasses, and you got a bonus case with it as well, a nice little hard case to keep the glasses in. And these glasses record in, again, 1080p, full HD video, at 30 frames a second, or you can shift it to 720p and record at 60 frames a second. The reason why I picked up these glasses, to be quite honest, is from looking at videos from the Tim Tracker. And he owns a pair as well. I know that he's used them for on-ride videos and things like that. And I have to be honest, I love my GoPro. It has so many different uses and so many different situations that you could use it in, and different mounts. I am forever going to be in love with this camera, especially for underwater things and action shots. But there's times that wearing these sunglasses or glasses with the camera built into them can be really beneficial. And what I'm thinking, again, ride videos, different types of first-person angles. Like I can think of right now, this coming week or the next week, we're going to head over to Universal and hopefully be balloon handlers. I'd love to be able to wear these and be able to hold the balloon and give you the perspective of what it's like to be in the parade as opposed to watching the parade. Those are types of things that I don't think you can really do with the GoPro, you know, because it's a little more noticeable. And these have a little bit more flexibility of being able to wear them and have them be a little bit unnoticed. So as I opened them up, you can see they have the specs on the bottom. And you can see that for video resolution, you can do, again, 1080p at 30 frames a second, or 25 or 24 frames a second, or 720p at 60, 50, 48, 30, 25, or 24. And it records an MP4 format. So easy to upload or edit to YouTube and other sites. And this uses a USB 2.0 cable for charging and to transfer your pictures or videos. So after opening up the tab on the first layer of the box, on the inside you can see where it says Nice Choice. And the box opens just to reveal the glasses, and they're held inside with another tab. I will say that if you go back, I would encourage you to watch the Tim Tracker's review of his pivot heads and the older box that they came in. I think was quite nicer than the packaging that they have now. I'm going to put a link to Tim's video in this video as well, so you can check that out. So this is what's in the box. A USB cord. They give you a booklet on like a quick, easy guide how to use the glasses. A booklet on accessories. You have a warranty. And they gave you this kind of sunglass bag. It's kind of cheesy or flimsy. I wouldn't have used it. I'm very happy that as part of the Black Friday deal, they gave you this harder case as well, so you know the glasses won't get smashed in my backpack. And then you have four simple steps to glory. So they're just telling you to open the box, charge them, put them on, and then share the clips. So I think what you'll see next is what they look like on me, and then I'm going to give you a video sample as well. Alright, so these guys took about an hour and a half or so to charge fully, so it took a little bit of time. And when you're charging, this right where my pinky is lights up green, and it's done. So we charge it by the USB micro cord, and let's try to test them out now. In order to take video, once they're on my head, if I push this button here forward quickly, it'll start recording in 1080p. If I hold it down, it'll record in 720p with 60 frames a second. If I hit this back button, that will take a picture or three shots at one time at 8 megapixels apiece. If you hold it, it does a time lapse. So let's test it out and see how it looks. I powered them on using that little button. Now the light is on, so let's rock. This is how the glasses look. So I can't see myself. I'm assuming they look somewhat stylish. I had a pair of Oakleys in the same Durango type style, so I think they look all right. I'm assuming so. Let's see how the video comes out. We're looking in the living room. This is where we have the TV. We need to move this into the guest bedroom for now because the TV's coming tomorrow, and there's our completed TV stand. With cats. And a mess all around the house, yes. But this is where things are, and there's Mary sitting there. So I'm going to move the glasses around a bit and see how they look. See if it looks a little crazy. So that's that. Let's head back to the den. Here's all of our Ghostbusters stuff. Alright, we're seeing if this is recording at 720, 60 frames, because I held it down a little bit longer than normal. So, hopefully that's what it is. This is me reading this book. Alright, so we're going to get another view with these. Now we're outside during the day. Want to see how much background noise you can pick up. There are birds in the background. Slow. I'm going to shake it a little bit faster. All right, there you go. So there you have it. The video quality looks pretty good. The 30 frames a second at 1080p looks really crisp. The 60 frames a second at 720p looks really fantastic. I can't wait to get these glasses outside, maybe on a ride, maybe outside playing sports as well, and test them out a little bit. So there you have it. Look for them at least, if not this weekend, and the following weekend when we get back to Universal Studios. So, thanks for watching, everybody.